Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Sonali Othit Football Night. Today we are discussing the District Cup, which consists of four districts of the Greater Sylhet District Division. That is Habibganj, Sunamganj, Sylhet, and Moulvibazar. And today I have some great guests with me. And first I will introduce the guests with me. On my left I have Anam. You are representing Sylhet.
I'm representing Sylhet.
And you're also managing 40 plus Sylhet team.
Yes, right, yeah.
And you are from Gulabganj.
Yeah, Assalamualaikum.
Islam. Welcome to the program, Anam. And then I have Mohit Bhai, Abdul Mohit Bhai, who is the organizing secretary of Sonali Othit UK. Mohit Bhai, welcome.
Assalamualaikum.
And on my right, I have Amdad Rahman, MBE. He is representing Sylhet District 50 plus team. He is the manager of the 50 plus team. And I'm sorry, Amdad, welcome to the program.
Assalamu alaikum, Janal Bhai. Thank you for welcoming us.
Waalaikumsalam. And then I have Abdul Mukid Nannu. He's also representing the Sylhet District team. He's the executive committee member of the Sylhet District team committee.
Assalamu alaikum.
Waalaikumsalam. Now, firstly, can I come to Anam?
Yeah, definitely.
The preparation for the 40 plus team, for the district team. Last year is the winner of Sylhet, wasn't it?
Yes. Yes, we were the winners, yeah.
So how is your preparation going this year?
Well, so far it's been good. First of all, I just want to say thanks for having us on the show. It's a great tournament organised by Sonali Othit. And secondly, I just want to thank the city district committee for giving me this opportunity to manage the team this year. So it's a great, very privileged for having this opportunity.
I know it's a very short gap between the Upojila Cup and the district, which is 3 weeks. So have you managed to have any friendlies or any training?
Well, our first session was on last Friday, where I had, I think, 26 players on show. 26 players, 45 plus players on the books. I'll have to narrow that down to 23. So it's going to be a very difficult challenge, but I'm looking forward to it.
Any new recruits from last year?
We have a lot of, newly 40 plus players that's turning up this year. So first session on Friday, we've got another one coming on tomorrow, so it's all up for grabs for these players to show me their talent.
How do you see opposition of the three? Which do you think will be a tough contest for?
On paper, I think Sunamganj should be the challenge for everyone. I think there's only four.
But I hear rumors Habibganj are coming strong, they say, because...
Yeah, obviously, I mean...
Because most of the players who played the
Upojila Club, yeah.
A lot of them qualify for the 40-plus team, and so that proves that they will be stronger because they are the champions of the Upojila Cup.
I think, General, but you cannot underestimate anybody in these tournaments, one-day tournaments, especially.
That's right, yeah.
So,
But the history says that Sonamganj and Sylhet, every year, these two teams went to the final.
Well, that's, I don't want to give away too much about my own team, but it's going to be very interesting on the day.
Okay, Mohibba, I'll come to you last year. I'm going to come to Amdad. Amdad, you are managing the 50 plus team.
Yes.
Now, the 50 plus team, it started as a kind of, for have some fun, but it seems to me it has become more crucial than the 40 plus, the way it's, the preparations are going. I mean, I've seen Sonamganj preparing for 2 months in advance. Last year, Sylhet started preparations 3 months in advance. The 50 plus team I'm talking about. How is it going this year?
It's absolutely manic. And you're absolutely spot on, General Bhai. When you look at, and this is actually a really positive thing. If you think of my greatest privilege is I'm the figurehead and I'm managing a group of people who, when I was a youngster, so I used to live near the old Sand Pitch and Cannon Street Road. I used to go and stand there as a kid and I used to watch these players play. So it's a huge privilege for me. You can imagine, I feel very privileged now watching that some of these guys who used to be my heroes when I was watching them play, I'm managing them as well. And you're absolutely right. They're very, very competitive. Actually, we actually put the over 40s in the shade. When you look at the commitment, the suggestions to the managers, the turn up for training, people putting their names out on the list, the desire to again retain the cup is huge, huge.
When you say heroes, that's fine. I mean, there are some figures there. Could we say your father figure, like Keshavai?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. you're absolutely spot on. You can, they're probably closer to my dad's age.
Yeah,
a lot of them. They're even seniors amongst the over 40s as well, who are very, very old. So, it's as you can imagine, it's quite an intriguing position for me. My greatest enjoyment comes out of the fact that I was asked what I would like to assist with the over 40s this year, maybe in some capacity or another. And I was very adamant, you know, I was speaking to Sarwar by our being as a representative on the Sylhet district panel. And I said to him, I'm having a lot of fun with the over 50s. And also the biggest challenge for me is engaging these over 50s, because they are very, very challenging. They're not the type who you're just going to say, you play in this position and you go right and you go left and you stick there. No, they're very opinionated and they're very, very strong. So to engage them is a challenge which I relish.
Last year, what part did you play in the 50 plus team?
I was the manager. This is my third consecutive.
Wow.
I'm very pleased to say this is my third consecutive
role
as head coach.
Last year, I think you lost out on penalties.
We did. It was very unfortunate. And again, those who had the privilege, you yourself for their journal, of watching the final, it was a tremendous final.
We enjoyed that.
The over 40s, there was a gap between the final and the last over 40s game, and we played the over 50s final in between. I mean, it was wonderful because there was a really nice touch from the over 40s teams. What they did was they formed a guard of honor for all of us.
The same this year.
Yeah. And me and Kahar, we led the team on. It was really, really great. It was very touching, you know, that the younger lot, they were given so much respect on that. The game itself was an absolute spectacle. It was blood and thunder. There was nothing friendly about the game. People were pulling in. People were bringing up.
It was friendly, but not friendly.
It was not friendly. People were bringing up old grudges from 10, 20 years ago. It was
piling onto
the pitch. Exactly. And unfortunately, when it came to penalties, we lost. Penalties are a lottery. But obviously, it hurts because we were the inaugural winners. You know, we created history by winning the first Sonali Othit Sylhet District Cup for the over 50s. That year, the over 40s lost the final. The results were reversed last year, with the over 40s won their first crown. We lost it again. But it's been a tough 12 months for us, and we're very, very determined to make a huge go of it on Sunday.
All the best, Emdat. Although I say all the best, you know, I'm from...
Of course.
I think I'll be one of the squad members this year, hopefully. Nanubai, this concept of this 40-plus and this 50-plus, what does it give the community? What do you think, as a representative of the Sylhet District Committee?
It brings everybody together, basically, and people over the age of 50, at least they keep on playing football, you know, at a competitive level, and it brings the whole community together. And Sonali doing a fantastic job, you know.
To some extent, like, you know, this thing of, like, we really believe that if this didn't exist, Sonali Othit or any veterans tournament didn't exist, then all these people would have been in football. Do you agree with that?
I agree. Because Sonali, as I mentioned, Sonali has been doing a fantastic job bringing the whole community together, especially
at this age,
yes. You know, there isn't any other organization who's playing this part in the community.
Okay, thank you. And just on the same thing, this concept, you know like, let me just give you some help on it. Some years ago, like 20 years back, we used to see when we were younger, we used to see 28, 29, 27. Well, once they got married, end of the story of football.
Yes.
Because they were with family life. It doesn't matter how old they were. But now to see people 60 at the age of 60 and plus, like Keshava is 60 plus, he's 64. Abdul Khalid Keshava, who everybody knows in the footballing community, he's well known by the name of Keshia, who's always involved with Shedwell all through his years. He never changed his team, one team man. So this concept, what do you think? What's your view?
I think it's a tremendous concept. And the proof in the pudding for me, General Bay, is I'm very analytical. And since the formation of Sonali Othit, we've had a regime which have taken Sonali Othit on one level. When we look at some of the personalities like Babul Bay, for example, and Aman Bay, these are people I know personally that I'm naming, and the great job that they did all these years as well. And then this happens is, democratically, we have a regime change. So automatically what happens is supporters and non-supporters alike, what they do is they say, right, let us see now what turn this organization takes. Do we still have the same level of confidence in this organization? Are they going to provide the same amount of service and integration? And are they going to welcome the community just like the older one did as well? And I was one of them. I support everybody, but I'm very analytical, so I can provide feedback. And I've got to congratulate Sonali Othit on this behalf, that the transition has been absolutely fantastic. And if we look at this concept of engaging with players over the age of 35, you made a very important point. because we're not professional footballers, you could almost say that the retirement age, and Amber, correct me if I'm wrong, the retirement age is often when the boys get married, because and when they, especially when they have their children.
Yeah, that's it.
When they got young children, their commitments are completely other. So football is the one thing that is sacrificed almost immediately. And then you see these beer bellies coming out and people putting on weight and people picking up smoking habits and things like that. So a great chunk of, they might come back years later, as we got with a few people now, but they're not the same as well. What Sonali Othit has done in between, and you'd be hard placed to find a concept like this all over the, if you look around models like this all over the world, you have veterans playing football, but the concept of engaging 35-year-olds, 40-year-olds, 40-plus, 50-plus, it's unheard of. And what he does, what he has done in terms of our community and other communities, because obviously I mix with other communities, it has revitalized the elderly folk within our community to the extent that even my father, he knows that I'm managing the over 50s, he's keeping regular tabs on what is going on. The Upazila Cup, I sent a picture to the Bianewaza team the day before. He saw me a bit down when we lost in the semi-finals again, General. So the next morning I saw my dad. I went in there. It made my heart so happy. I saw him there. My dad had washed the kit and he was hanging them up. So I took a discreet picture of him and I sent it to him. I said, make dua for my dad. He's washing your kits. And, you know, he saw me a little bit down. So he thought, I'll wash the kits for my... And so Rabbi immediately, he ordered a kit for my father to present it to another. Wow. So you can imagine the engagement that even my dad, who's now in his 80s, although he's not playing, but he's seen his son engaging with people who are 40s, 50s. Remember, there's a player, Nurul Haq, who used to be one of the most fantastic players from within our community from Gulaf Gonj, back in the days. He was one of the people I used to go and watch. So he's my mama, through relation. So he retains, my mum and dad have retained an interest. How is he doing? How's Bodrul doing? So you can see what you have done as an organization, how you've brought the community not only together as well, but you've also engaged with people who have generally would have had no interest in football.
I think we should also thank the sponsors, whoever they were, you know, that because of the sponsors, this thing has become a reality. Because without the finance, it's not possible. Everybody in here knows That's right, very well. So a special thanks to the sponsor
absolutely.
On behalf of Sonali Othit and the footballing community of Bangladesh in London, in the UK. with the concept again, I'm going to come to you as well. I mean, the other day I had a phone call from one of the Bishnat players.
Okay.
He's a Bishnati player and he said his in-laws are in Chatok. So Shoshurbari Chatok.
So he wants to play Chatok now?
No.
Okay. You're going in a different angle. Okay. All right.
No. Even if he did, he wouldn't have the guts to say that to
okay.
me.
Okay. Well, let's get that clear then.
Now, the request is because he's Shoshurbari in Chatok, his wife is Chatoki, and his wife demanded the tops of Chatok. She wants to wear it.
Yeah.
And the two kids. The two kids want to wear the Chatoki top. I mean, see this concept, like where it is going. It's going into families now. The other day, I had another player. He's Molly Bajari, and his Shoshurbari is Balagonj, okay? And now his son and his wife are in favor of Balagonj. And they're phoning him, texting him, what's the result of Balagonj, you know? So what do you think about this thing?
I mean,
household.
I just want to touch on that point that you made, General. I mean, I've got nothing left to say because Emdad Bhai said everything we need to. But just wanted to touch a point on that particular, you know, when he said what you guys done, Sonali Othit. I was in Bangladesh for the last 3 weeks, and while the Upazila Cup was going on, my 13-year-old son and my 16-year-old son, now they know where they're from, Gulab Gunj. So I stayed in my sister's place for a while in Badeshwar. They were keeping a tap on what's going on, how the Gulab Gunj team is doing. I was trying to keep away from that because I knew they weren't doing that good. So this is what you've, Sonali Othit, have put through even to the youngsters. Forget the vets now, forget the 35 plus, forget the 40 plus. Now we've engaged the youngsters to participate and go and support in your Upazilas, go and support in your district and seeing what it's all about. So I think, again, it's a great tournament. Mm. Sonali Othit has done an amazing part in the last 4 years, 5 years, bringing everyone together.
But it all comes with the help of every team.
Every team, every support.
Upazila level or normal level, because we do have the masters where normal team plays, where the league team plays. We have the masters, we have the Upazila, we have the district. Now we are coming up with another one called Five Nations, so which will include Nepal, Sri Lanka, India, Pakistan and Bangladesh,
okay,
which will be announced very shortly. Mohit Bhai, can I come to you now?
Yes, please.
I'd like to hear about your Sonali Othit. You were the organizing secretary, Could you give us some input on how Sonali Othit is doing?
Thank you, General Bhai.
Bangla abar bolte paren.
Boltam parbo. Thank you. Dhonnobad. Up to now, Sonali Othit is ekta korche. Khub sundor, khub bhalo. Karon amra guest hole je tarif kore amdar. Mani oktao ar amra je upojela je ekta khela amra Sonali Othit e dise. আমরা যে সোনালী অতীত কমিটির বাইন যারা যেরকম কাজ করছে অত সুন্দর কাজ করছে আমি সোনালী অতীত কমিটি বাইন তোরে থ্যাংক ইউ দিলাম আর যারা টিম হল আইছো গ্রেটার যে সিলেট ডিস্ট্রিক্ট মানে সাইটটা যে
ডিস্ট্রিক্ট
ডিস্ট্রিক্ট তো নাইছো একটা জিনিস জোনাল ভাই আপনার লগে আমি শেয়ার করমু আমরা যে বাঙালি কমিউনিটি যারা এই কাজটা করতে পারছে না সোনালী অতীতও কাজটা করছে বৃহত্তর সিলেট ডিস্ট্রিক্টর যে সাইটটা ডিস্ট্রিক্ট আছে যে এক করিয়া যে আমরা এক হয়ে গেছে বা এন্তরে আনিয়া যে একটা প্ল্যাটফর্ম আনিয়া যে খেলা দিছে যে মানে এক অন্যর লগে পরিচয় আমি দক্ষিণ সুরমার বায়ুলা বিয়ানী বাজার বায়ুলা গোলাপগঞ্জর আমরা সিনডাম এক অন্যরে সিনডাম যে করলাম কিন্তু অক্টার লাগি আমি যে সোনালী অতীতরে মানে আমার কমিটিরও আমি আমার তরফ থেকে থ্যাংক ইউ দিলাম যে বাইনতে যে আমরা যে গেস্ট হলে যে আমরা তারিফ করা ওটা শুনিয়াও আমি খুব খুশি আর কিছু কন আমার
So apart from the team, how do you look at the sponsors? I mean, sponsor of Robusta, Digita, Amara, sponsor of Lutuna, Tikitulo Nobusta.
The sponsor of Lutum main to Tara Bayan Tizera, the Bayan Uriaida. The one under the Kishum under the Duita Kidas, Duita Group under the support words. Aroman Namkitam, Arod Bayan the Huraz under the Shomaduka under the Tam Sairam. The Monone Ubojala Setara, Mani Kurazamda, Otobos or Duriam, Arador Haramda Dimu, Arodimu, Manizu Horalagi.
Which is nice.
Nice.
Which is nice. Just dear viewers, we'll go for a very, very short break. Please stay with us. Don't go anywhere. Thank you. See you soon.